Soon, I'll be teaching you a wonderful slow-cooked dessert.
Now look at the colour on them. The smell is incredible.
But first, five more of my 100 tips to make your home cooking easier. Starting with how to cook duck breast perfectly, the slow way.
Duck breast. Never be scared about cooking this bird. Absolutely delicious, very healthy. First, oven on, 200 degrees. And then, salt, pepper. Now the salt will help to extract the water out of the fat. Non-stick pan, no oil, but start the duck breast in the pan cold. Skin side down, it feels and sounds a little bit weird. But as we put them into a cold pan and turn the heat up gradually, it starts to release the fat. If we put them into a hot pan, it seals them in and the fat stays in there. We want to render that fat down. 90% of that duck breast will be cooked on its skin. Keeps the duck nice and moist, but more importantly, it stays crispy. Once the fat comes out, turn the duck over. Nice, high, hot heat. Seal the duck. Now they're going in the oven, skin side down. 200, 6 to 8 minutes. If your pan's got a plastic handle on it, then transfer the duck breast onto a tray, but make sure you put the tray into the oven to get hot first. Cooking duck is like cooking a piece of beef. You can't slice it piping hot, all the goodness runs out. Just quickly turn it over, push your fingers in there, and it's slightly resistant, but still quite bouncy. And that confirms they're quite pink in the center. But the important part now is leaving that to rest, let them cool down, and then we'll slice them. Keep that excess duck fat, and there you go. Next time you're sauteing potatoes, you just take them to a completely different level. Now, slicing the duck, just slice it at an angle, not too thin. If you slice it thinly, it goes cold quickly, so nice, thick slices. Nice, crispy skin on top, and a beautiful, plump, roasted duck. All the white fat gone, nice, crispy skin, and absolutely delicious.
Another slow cooking tip is, when slow cooking stews and casseroles, fat will rise to the surface. To get rid of any excess oils, my tip is to remove them with kitchen paper before serving. This also works brilliantly on gravies and sauces. Many great slow cooked dishes start by browning the meat. As the meat cooks, lots of flavors get stuck to the pan. To get it into your sauce, deglaze with wine, stock, or vinegar. Never add soft herbs at the beginning of slow cooking. They're all too delicate. The tip is to add them at the end for that hit of fresh flavor and vibrant color. A great tip when frying fish is to always fry skin side down to keep it crispy. And always lay the fillets away from you when adding to the pan to prevent hot oil from splashing towards you. Slow cooking isn't exclusive to just savory dishes. It's a clever way to transform fruit into wonderful desserts, giving them an amazing sticky, jammy intensity. Invest a bit of patience and my next recipe pays off big time. Indulgent and bursting with flavor. Caramelized figs with ricotta.
Slow cooking can also take desserts to a whole new level. A gentle, long cook can really bring out that wonderful, rich, sticky sweetness and that depth of flavor in fruits. These are black figs. They are suited to slow cooking, roasting, better than the green figs, because this outside skin is so durable. This is an amazing way of roasting figs, and it's so easy, yet so delicious.
Lay your figs out in rows.
Take some rosemary and just peel that down. Get that really nice, fragrant stem. Get your scissors, trim the edge. Almost we've got a bit of a sort of sharp point. Bring your three figs together and just thread the top of each fig nice and gently.
Rosemary works wonderfully with sweet dishes. As the figs roast in the oven, the stalk will impart a lovely, subtle flavor.
Beautiful.
Dust the figs with icing sugar, then coat them with a generous splash of balsamic vinegar.
Leave them to sit there for 5 minutes and they sort of marinate.
I know it sounds odd to use vinegar in your dessert, but trust me, it gives the dish a fantastic sweet and sour taste.
I'm gonna make a really nice caramel. four or five tablespoons of sugar. Now, flatten that out and get it nice and even. When the sugar is even, caramel cooks evenly. It's changing now. You can see it melting from the outside in. The one thing you don't do is shake the pan rapidly. And see it almost like sort of a lake defrosting, and it's hitting to the center, bubbling. Still not dark enough yet. It's getting there. Turn the gas down and stay in control.
Let the sugar melt until it turns a dark amber color.
The secret behind any good caramel is just stopping it from overcooking. Lovely. Take that off the gas. Knob of butter in there. Just gently whisk in the butter. It's cooling the caramel down. You'll see it changing color to like a cafe au lait.
Next, add a glug of the balsamic vinegar.
Nice. Beautiful. Got that nice, dark richness of the caramel. A little touch of water in there. That way the caramel doesn't go too thick.
Now put the caramel back on the heat.
Take your figs and sort of place them in gently. Lovely. And then just add all that lovely little marinade. Mmm, don't waste that. That's amazing stuff there. Now, ice and sugar and balsamic vinegar. There's something so tasty. Baste those figs. Because the skin gets nice and crispy on the outside. And the fig sort of just absorbs the caramel. Delicious. So easy. Now, into the oven. 190 for 10 minutes. Almost doubled in size. Now look at the colour on them. The smell is incredible. Onto your plate. They're a lot heavier because they've actually started absorbing that caramel.
Now douse the figs with caramel. And serve with ricotta cheese.
The freshness of that ricotta goes brilliantly well with the figs. I'm gonna finish that now with some zest and then some little nibbed almonds and the rich, creamy jam texture of the fig with the ricotta goes brilliant. That is an amazing way of slow roasting fruit and taking figs to a completely new level.
Follow my ultimate cookery course, crammed with key lessons. Top tips and 100 recipes to stake your life on, and you'll literally be cooking yourself into a better chef. Go on, get cooking. Next time, more slow-cooked favourites. A trio of fantastically easy-to-prepare slow-cooked suppers. How to get incredible meat without breaking the bank.
Don't be scared of them. They're really economic, but full of flavour.
And my ultimate slow-cooked pork recipe, guaranteed to deliver every time.
That is amazing.